all starts with something called inspiration. You have to have an idea. You have to have an itch, which perhaps you cannot scratch. Yeah? So something interesting. Software, hardware, tech startup. Yeah? I want to take you through my idea, my tech startup, in terms of how I got involved. I also want to take you through perhaps the journey of where we've been going, what is the idea I'm talking about, where we've been, and perhaps some lessons and learnings which I've actually, in a short space of time, thought of what Toastmasters means to me and to this tech startup. Is it something you'd like to hear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this workshop, I would like to conduct in a slightly different way. I would like you, at any time, if you like, to interrupt me. I would like to know your opinion as well. So it's a free-flowing thing. At any time, put up your hand, not that I'm going to answer it, but ask me some questions. That's very fine. Yeah? So, question number one. Here's my question. How many tech startups, what's the percentage which actually fail in under 3 years?
C.
Yeah? You got it right. That was an easy question. I'm starting to warm you up. Now, the point being is that most ideas, actually, that's all they become, an idea, and then they're swept away in the sea of ideas. Yeah? The next question, what percentage of tech startups actually get investor funding?
B.
All right. The answer is D. D for David. Less than 1% of ideas get funded. Yeah? So over 99% of people and ideas, they just get faded away. Yeah? Now, you could say it's a risky business. You could say that perhaps it's better just to take your money and go to Macau. Your chances perhaps there are perhaps better than playing in the tech startup market. Yeah? Now, let me take you back over 6 months ago. Yeah? There I was, involved in my day job. I was approached by some very old friends. And they said, Mark, we've got this idea. And I'll expand on what this idea is in a minute. And they said, look, we've got to share this with the rest of the world, this wonderful idea. So we went to this place called Cocoon Hong Kong, which is an incubator. In other words, it's a place where tech startups begin to grow. And lo and behold, after we pitched very hard in front of some very accomplished speakers and judges, we only had 4 minutes. It's sort of like Toastmasters, a prepared speech, but we only have 4 minutes. And even worse than Toastmasters, after that, they've got 3 minutes to ask really hard questions. Yeah? So that's the first learning. Never think that when you go to Toastmasters, it's just in one ear and out the other. There's so many things you can learn from being here today. And guess what? We won. We were the winning team. But where did that take us to? Yeah? It took us to something called, that's my better looking twin brother. It took us to something called RISE Conference in Hong Kong. Now the RISE Conference, for those of you who don't know, this is where people speak, like Elon Musk, who's Mr. Tesla, yeah? People like Bono, which is U2, and even myself, I speak at these conferences. We were invited to actually pitch a 4-minute pitch in front of a large audience. There was a total audience there over 2 days of around 5,000 people. Yeah? Having said that, we pitched to a lot less, say perhaps 400 or 500 people, if that. Yeah? And you've got 4 minutes to tell them about your ideas and 3 minutes questions. Now, what is the whole idea of this? It's to get an investor partner to come along with you on your idea. In other words, to take them and their money with you on your journey. Yeah? So you've got to be powerful, you've got to be effective. Do they believe in your idea? Do they believe in your leadership and your team? Yeah? Do they want to come with you on your journey? All of these questions. Yeah? Then, we went to Sun Yat-sen University in Guangzhou. Has anyone ever been there? Yeah? Now, what's interesting too, people think, look, all the good ideas, it's just in Hong Kong, rest of the world. What really surprised me as a tech startup was the amount of energy and ideas actually coming out of Guangzhou and some of the young students in China. I'm one of the older guys. And just the amount of wonderful ideas, things like websites where you can go to if you lose your boyfriend or girlfriend. Yeah? Virtual reality, which you could say is the same thing. So many incredible ideas. And we actually pitched at that university there in front of investors. But what makes that environment even more interesting is that you're allowed as much time, so it's rowdy people walking in and out of that conference. And more than that, anyone can throw questions at you. So it was tough, a great sort of learning environment for us. Yeah? Now, is it something, having said that, would you like to learn more about our idea? Mm. Yeah? Okay, what is our idea and where are we today? And perhaps even the take homes of what we've learned going forward. Yeah? So, before I do the investor pitch, 4 or 5 minutes, or even shorter, get your idea across and get the buy-in from the investor. And what it's about, you've got to be super effective. You've got to be able to sell your ideas to anyone. Because you don't have half an hour, you've got less than 5 minutes. Think of it like Toastmasters, but on caffeine. Yeah? So, here's the formula within an investor startup pitch. What is the problem? Okay. What problem are you trying to solve? The second thing, what solution are you prescribing to that problem? Importantly, as I said before, is who are you? What is your credibility? Why should I invest in your idea? Yeah. And lastly, how much is it going to cost, and what's the return going to be? So you've got to tell a hell of a lot of things in a short amount of time. Again, if you don't have a lot of time, you've got to be able to swing in every single word and make it effective. Because investors, they have very short attention span. Some would say they have attention deficit disorder, ADD. Because everyone is trying to cotton on to these investors. Yeah? And you're just one of many others. Okay, so what is the idea which we have? Here's my question to you. Have any of you dropped these things, smartphones, into water? Yeah? There's a few of you. Here's the incredibly interesting statistic. That's right. Over 35% of phones have been dropped in water. Now, we asked people, and 50% of people would actually pay. And then 35% would actually use a spray solution. So today, fellow Toastmasters and potential investors, that is the solution. My phone, water repellent spray. It contains 4 safe ingredients. It's proven water repellency, and it's been tested by EU experts. So that's our simple pitch. And it's been proven by independent test laboratories. Yeah? Now, that is the whole simple idea. Now, why are we going for just the smartphone market? It's the most lucrative market in the world. It's growing and it's dynamic. And it's a pain point for the phone industry. We could have gone into electrical, electronic industry for many different applications, but we decided on the mobile phone market because we saw a huge gap within that market there. Yeah. Something which we can use within 15 minutes. But enough of me telling you about it. How about me showing you how it works? So we opened up a phone and we sprayed it. Yeah. All the parts which come into contact, including the battery and the SIM card. And we did something silly. We dropped it in water. And it's still ringing. Who's going to answer that? Now, simply put, our sales channels is very much on the retail market. We've had great expressions of interest from Europe, United States, and even South America for this. But we mustn't forget the e-retailers. And then there's many industrial applications for anything which is used outside and is prone to water. Now, again, we're looking at wholesale, $7.50 US, and retail, $15 US. Yeah? Something simple, easy to use, which you can buy when you buy your phone. Who are the people you're going to be investing in and driving this business? Aside from myself, there's two other gentlemen there. Mr. Roger Pan, who is based in Shenzhen, and my partner, Paul Van Branklen. We've known each other for over 10 years, and our focus has very much been on e-retailers. As we say, we're going to try and save your phone one spray at a time.